fast.
Wonderful day here in South Trinidad. I like to think in Trinidad as a whole, the sun is shining. When we left Port of Spain this morning, it was glorious. Confirmation of that power play, Guardian Life. Their bonus strike rate this season has been 93. And he's making an effort as Fawad Ahmed comes into the attack. Bonner to try to get his tempo going early. Good thing about T20s is that you can play with a certain sense of freedom. Like that. Nice shot. And with the boundaries equidistant from the middle, you get value for your shots all around the ground today.
Nicely played. This wasn't that short. Managed to get deep in his crease, which allowed him enough time to get on top of the bounce and cut that away. Fawad Ahmed won't mind that. He's got a slip in place. And that's why he won't mind it. Because it brings the keeper the slip in play when the ball is not that short. There is that risk attached to it. Yeah.
Oh, wide, go fast, go fast.
Good running, tools are available. They haven't always been good players rotating the strike for Talawas this season.
Lovely stuff here, lads. Come on, boys.
In fact, they've got, as you said, Tom, that dot ball percent.
Yeah, out of all the six teams, they've got the highest dot ball percentage. Now, their team is geared for power hitting, for hitting boundaries. And as it's been touched on in the previous stint by Darren Ganga and Danny Morrison, they're all geared as right-handers too.
One.
This will be a comfortable two, which is quite remarkable, really, when you think about it, that you would, in a tournament, set your squad up, particularly your batting lineup, up with so little options with left-right batting combinations, because we've seen that being so important, particularly against spin. A good over, nine coming from it. It's 37 for four.
Blackwood went in Hussein's first over. Phillips went cheaply. Mujeeb surprisingly coming in at three. Asif Ali, after a decent start to the tournament where he got 47 against the Zooks, has fallen away dramatically. Bonner going well, 26 from 24. Hard to pick at that pace from that length.
It's also hard to pick when Narayan is hiding the ball behind his hip. It's a new delivery he's developed over the last 18 months, I'd say nearly 2 years, where he hides the ball. He's got two different ways of doing it, showing it on the left. And that's how he has bowled for the last 10 years or so. But the one on the right, he just tucks it behind his hip so the batsman has no clue as he's coming in. And that's through a misfield, and it should run away for a all-important boundary.
Ali Khan, and I reckon that the Knight Riders have given away maybe about 12 runs minimum so far this morning. Five wides by Carey Pierre, a couple of misfields that have gone to the boundary. Webster got his feet onto the boundary while pulling the ball back.
With Narayan hiding the ball like he has developed over the last 18 months, it makes it very, very difficult for the batsman. We talk about how important it is to try to read the ball out of the spinner's hand, but if you're not getting any cue at all before the ball is delivered, it makes it doubly hard, particularly against a mystery spinner like Narayan. We'll have another look at that split screen, and just hopefully you'll appreciate, sitting at home, how tricky it must be for the batsman. And you've got such a clever bowler like Narayan asking questions constantly to whether it's going to turn into your stumps or turn away or go straight on. So this is his normal delivery. So you get half a chance from a batting perspective in the load up to be able to look to where the fingers are positioned on the ball. Here, you're getting absolutely nothing until the ball arrives on top of his head. Nicely worked into leg. For one to complete the eighth over, it's 42 for four. See the ball just swivel in his fingers just before he loads it up to deliver it. It's a real skill, the way that the ball can just move around Narayan's hand before he delivers it. Once he decides what ball he's going to bowl or what ball he's not going to bowl.
Wickets to fall, starting with Blackwood, then Glenn Phillips, uncharacteristic of him, then Mujeeb. Some contention as to whether Mujeeb actually hit it.
Lovely lads, lovely boys.
The fourth wicket to go down was Asif Ali.
Yeah, which is a very similar dismissal to Phillips. Both